what Angular 2 material design. So most of the speakers before me talked about Angular 2. So let's wrap it up and let's put some design on that Angular 2. So a brief introduction about me. I'm very nervous right now. Pardon me if I talk something wrong there. So I'm Paul Gonzalez, and I just graduated last year. I had worked on some projects that uses Grunt, Backbone, React Native, Angular 2, and Elementary 2. And I'm lucky because when I graduated, most of the companies that I have went into, they let me use those recent technologies. So right now, I will be talking about Angular 2 material design. So, I just have my cheat sheet. So, without further ado, let's introduce me. So first of all, what is material design? So material design, or also known as quantum paper, is a design language developed in 2014 by Google. So anyone in here who owns an Android phone with the latest version of operating system, like Lollipop, Nougat, Marshmallow, know what? So I think, yeah. What do you guys have of your phones? So yeah. So most of the Android phones nowadays use as material design, like this one. Yeah. See. Most of the Google applications uses material designs for their applications such as YouTube, Google Mail, Altos, and also Google uses it on their websites, like this one, Google Wallet and Google Reward. Okay, so why not build an Angular 2 website using Material Design? So let me introduce to you this package, Material Design for Angular 2, or yeah. It is currently on the 2.0.0 Alpha 9-3. So one might ask me, why am I introducing this to you? Why use this package when there are so many available packages similar to this out there? We have, what you call this? we have similar package to this, like Semantic UI, yeah, Bootstrap. Yeah, thank you for that. You saved me. So it is number one. It is fast. So according to their website, it is fully tested on most of the most of the web browsers nowadays, including Internet Explorer 11, even though no one uses Internet Explorer nowadays, Chrome, Edge, Firefox, and Safari. It is versatile, it is teamable and customizable, and it is internationalized for the most users to use. So later on, I will show you how it is so versatile. And it is built by the same company or developers that brought to you Angular 1 and Angular 2. Okay, next one. Currently, these are the documented components as of October 17. October 17 is the day that I created this. So I don't know if they have released another component. So now they have if we can see this on there, like this. Okay, material design. Sorry. It's not my laptop, it's my muscles. Yeah. So here it is. This is their GitHub. So you can see in here the documented ones which had README. There are some issues. Also, there are these ones that is not being yet started. So, this is even me. Pardon me. Oh no, I got lost. Wait. My presentation. No, not that. That's for later. Yeah, it's on. Yeah, this one. Gotcha. Okay, so. Yeah, let's go to the installation. It can be installed through NPM. So it is on their documentation, NPM install -save. It is a plug to save it on their package JSON. And then the package name, @angular/material. Okay, next up, Angular 2 uses TypeScript, so in here we can see that it uses TypeScript. So you will import material module from the Angular slash material, which is located inside the node modules. Then you can see some other imports for your app. And then ng module imports material module for root. The material module encapsulates all of the components for the Angular material design. When I used this, it was, I think it's on Alpha 8, but now it's on Alpha 9. When I used this, I had to import all of the components one by one on the imports. But luckily now, they have encapsulated it inside a one import. So next is import the styles. This is the one that I've been telling to you that it is versatile. It can be themed. Like, we will just import this theme on your styles.css, which is like this. We have this deep purple ember.css, which uses the same colors that are being used, the color palette that is being used by the Google devs for their Angular material designs. So we have this deep purple is the one that will be used as the primary color. And then the ember is the one that will be being used as the secondary color, like in here. Let's go back here just a little bit. Okay, in here. So yeah, this one is the primary color. And then the buttons should be, or the accent, should be the secondary color. So later on, I will show you some demonstration. Okay, example, this is the one. Yeah, this is the one that I have built using Angular 2 material design. It uses the components navbar, tabs. Also, it uses the fab button, which can be seen on most of the material design themes. And then it uses these. And then these are all the components available. We have this black button raised, primary raised, accent raised, which is the secondary color. We have this checkboxes and check under mean determinate. We have these radio buttons, we have input boxes. We have this progress bars. Yeah. We have these tabs, and we have this icon. So now I will be showing to you how to show the side node. Okay. So this is the code that I have prepared. Pardon me if it's just simple. Okay. So now here we called our side node layout, which encapsulates our whole application. Okay, we called the side node, which will hold the design for the site navigation in here, the one that we'll show or toggle later on. Also, this one, MD toolbar, which uses the color primary. As I have said earlier, that we have imported it on our styles.css. This one, deep purple ember.css. Okay, so deep purple is the primary color. So, which in the case in here, I have used the deep purple as the primary color. Yeah, and we have the tab group. The tab group is the one that I've been using in here. Yeah, this one. Okay. So yeah, okay. Let's see how we can do the toggling of the side tab. So in here, according to their documentation, right? It's in here. The side nav can be shown using. Yeah. The side tab can be shown using toggle. Yeah. Toggle. Yeah. So in here, the button that we want to click that can show toggle is this one. So we just input click. It's equal to the name of the side tab, which is side tab. That toggle. It's just that easy. You just have to reload it. me, I'm reloading this, but it's also the Angular 2 didn't have its own hot reload function, so you don't have to reload it every time you edit your thing. So let's try if it works. Okay, so it works, but without the design. I just commented out the design. Yeah. Lalev coding. Thank you. So let's just wait for the hot reload, or in my case, I want it fast. Loading. And then. Ta-da! Okay. Yeah. You can see it, it's like on the conventional Google Play Store. Like, they have this design too. So, yeah, it's because Google uses mostly Google uses Material Design on most of their applications. So, back to my. Yeah. So, if you want to copy or check out the material demo, you can see it on my GitHub. Yeah, Pablo Gonzalez / Angular 2 Material Demo. And then, yeah, thanks. Yeah, it's just a brief discussion. So, any more questions? Any questions? Any questions? Oh, okay. So, this one. Not exactly, sorry, what?
Maybe the
hats color. Oh, okay. So, in here, if we can see it on my demonstration, we are using this as a white color. So if we will just only put it in here, the side lab that holds all of the design, we will just put color is equals to like secondary, which is hopefully this works. Okay. Let's just try it. I think Angular 2 Material Design has not yet fully documented it for the sidebar. So I think color can only be used on buttons and radio button, checkboxes, this loading, and this navigation bar. I think Angular 2 Material Design team made it the site now not to be customized by the color for the user, for them to fully customize it using CSS. So I think if you want your site now to be colored like the purple ember, I think you will just have to use CSS for it. Yeah, that's it. Any questions?
Yeah. How about the
theme
provider in Angular
Material 1? Angular Material 1. Yeah, I haven't toggled Angular Material 1, sorry. When I started using Angular Material 2 and Angular Material 1. So I think maybe someone can know the answer on this question that uses Angular 1.
Does anyone else have the answer? It's using Angular 1 with Material 1?
Sorry, I can't answer your question. I'm just using Angular 2. So that's it. Thank you for listening.
Awesome. Alright guys, so thank you very much for coming out. This was our 12th monthly meeting, right? So thank you all for coming out. If you want to hang out with us tonight, we're going out afterwards, right? Because we party, we're developers. Come up with us. Talk to the person sitting next to you, right? That's a pretty cool person, right? The videos will be online. We're going to post the videos. All the speakers, send me your decks, right? Wherever you are. Send me your decks so I can send them out to everybody. I'll send them out through Facebook and...